we're very happy to see that Jamaica is moving towards a plea bargaining system. We really don't want the lickle guys working in the boiler room having to tie up the Jamaican courts. We want them to flip on their bosses, provide testimony, either in a Jamaican court or in a U.S. federal court. This sort of conspiracy, not some guy who's working in a boiler room making 10 calls a day. So we very much welcome the introduction in the Senate of the plea bargaining legislation here in Jamaica, and we expect that's going to be a way to efficiently deal with these criminals, and of course other criminals, gang members, gun runners, narco traffickers, and murderers as well.
How difficult was this case for you to put together?
A lot of man hours by myself, Scott Horn for the most part, a lot of the postal inspectors, and did a great job between the FBI and the postal inspectors.
The indictment I saw from the other quarter listed about 26 Jamaicans who are wanted as part of the Laverick Willis organization. Give us an update as to how far you've reached in terms of who you've captured, how many you've captured, where are the others, and what are the efforts you're going to make to get them.
These guys are presently on indictment with 15 people. Anybody out, I couldn't comment on. There's other people who have been who already been convicted in prior indictments.
So there's older guys. Like Sanjay Williams.
And some others.
All parts of the Jamaican security forces have been vital partners with U.S. federal law enforcement in dealing with, investigating, and providing the evidence for these indictments here in Jamaica and in the United States. And I really want to thank, let's get a handshake here, the role of the JCF. This would not be possible. There are no investigations that happen here in Jamaica that are not joint investigations led by the JCF. The U.S. federal law enforcement does not investigate on a freelance basis.
So what is happening here today is an indication of the results we can get when we collaborate together as law enforcement partners. A lot of work was done in this particular case with our international partners, but locally, the counterterrorism and organized crime agent, MOCA, as also our DIPA team, the fugitive apprehension team, they did a lot of work, and our intelligence unit as well, to bring these persons in. So the extradition order was, issued last year. They went to court and the judge ordered that they be extradited, and was signed off by the minister, and they are now going abroad to face charges for conspiracy to the fraud, as well as mail fraud and electronic fraud, as a result of what we refer to in Jamaica as the lottery scamming. It's a big thing for us here in Jamaica. Some of the persons who are being extradited here today were taken into custody previously from as early as 2009. But as you might be aware, that we did not get a law that covers this thing until 2013. So it goes to show that if you run afoul of the law, time, it will catch up eventually.